in the initial stage. So it is my advice to attend each and every lecture, because whatever I am telling you, it is basics only. So once your base is strong, then you will be able to do the advanced thing, or you can do the designing. Okay, so small things I am telling, so you please understand, because if suppose later if you have any confusion, so you may will go in the wrong direction. So you please be careful, because these basics no one will tell you later. Everyone will ask you the advanced thing, you design multiplexer, you design adder, you design this, you design that, but no one will tell you the small things. Okay, so this is your as per your syllabus, main things they ask you in the syllabus. So small thing I am telling you, and I will give you example also. So please try to understand. If any confusion, you please resolve it timely. Don't think that I will resolve this later. Okay. I already told you about the logic levels, and I told you about the logic, how many type of logics were there. Two possible logic were there, positive logic and negative logic, right? So if you start with the logical operation, you will start with the black box. Suppose you don't know the gate, okay, so you will assume that this is a black box and you don't know what is inside. It is AND gate, OR gate, any gate may be there in the black box, you don't know. Okay, so based on the operation, what are the operation, that means you are giving input A and B and you are observing output Z. Okay, so whatever input combination you are giving, you are getting Z. Okay, so that you will write in the form of truth table. Okay, that you are writing in the form of truth table. So let's say this truth table you found for this black box. Okay, so I already told you the properties of the various gates. For example, I told you that AND gate operation is, if suppose you get only one if all inputs are one, and rest for all cases you will get zero. This type of property I told you about the AND operation. Okay, so various logical operation I discussed, and I was saying you that if this is the case, then this gate, if this is the gate, then this gate, like this I already told you. So now I am telling you what will be the effect if we are changing label logic from positive to negative, or negative to positive. So I am starting with the black box, and I am saying this is a black box. Here I don't know what is inside. I am giving the name digital gate. I only know the input and I only observe output. Okay, so that whatever input I am giving, I am listing in the truth table as L, as if I my voltage is in the range 0 to some voltage. So I am saying, if suppose it is 0 volt, I am saying I am writing L. If it is H, I am writing means 1 volt. I am assuming 5 volt. 5 volt means I am assuming 1 H. So here I am telling the truth table in terms of H and L. H means high, L means low. So in terms of high and low, I made a truth table. So if I am giving low at A and B, I will get is output Z low. So that I am observing in the CRO. So you are giving input to a toggle switch. You are connecting with the 0 volt and the 5 volt. So this switch is 0 volt or 5 volt. So this is the switch. So that switch will toggle either on 0 volt and 5 volt. So if it is in this, it is connected with this point, that is it is connected with 5. If it is connected with the this point, then it is 0 volt. Likewise here also. So we are giving input through a toggle switch. So the connection will decide whether we are connecting with this port terminal 0. So it is low. If it is connected with 5, it is high. This is a general assumption, and we are observing this output on the oscilloscope. On the oscilloscope or CRO, you are observing the output, or you can also see the you can measure the voltage on the multimeter. So you got this truth table. Here I am mentioning LL, LH. So it is giving L, HL. It is giving L, HH. It is giving H. So like this, we got the truth table. Now it is our wish. What we assume for L, what we assume for H. So if we assume L as 0 volt, and if we assume H as 5 volt, so that I already told you, it is your positive logic. So if I am assuming positive logic and I am drawing a truth table like this, so once we got this truth table with H and L, and now we are converting this H and L based on the positive logic. So you observe this table. I converted L as 0. I converted H as 1. So you see, you got this table if you assume positive logic. And if you go through this truth table, what you found that in this truth table, we got the property that output is 1 when all inputs are 1. The rest case, it is 0. So which gate it is telling us? It is AND operation. So whatever truth table, it is actually representing my AND gate. So positive logic, if I am assuming, it is my AND gate. Now, if suppose you are assuming negative logic, means same combination input and output I am taking. If suppose I am assuming negative logic, what I am assuming in negative logic, I will represent L as 5 volt and I will represent as H as 0 volt. That means it is my logic 1, it is my logic 0. So now I am complementing the nature of the L and H. Previously I was taking H equal to 5 volt as logic 1, L is equal to 0 volt as logic 0. Now I change the logic from positive to negative. So you see the difference in the truth table for the same L and H. So I replace L as 1, I replace H as 0. So you observe, what you observe? That this table is opposite. If you see that the decimal equivalent of this combination, it is 3. It is 3, it is 2, it is 1, it is 0. Here if you see the binary combination, decimal equivalent, it is 0, it is 1, it is 2, and it is 3. So you see the combination, just we change the order from 0 to 3. Here my order is changed from 3 to 0. But if you see the property of this this truth table, if you see the truth table, what you found? Which gate it is telling you? This truth table is related to which gate? Anyone please tell me? Anyone observe?
R gate.
R gate. So what we can do, what we can say, that whatever input we are giving, actually we are complementing. See, this A is now 1. This B is now 1. 0 to 1 we are complementing. So what we can say, that we are giving a complemented input and it is doing OR operation. And this operation, this OR output is also, it is complemented. So it is showing you the dual nature of the gate. Once you are changing your positive to negative logic, your property of the gate is changed. But my point, what I am saying, that if you are changing from positive to negative logic, your gate operation will change. Got it? Everyone got it? So what is the importance of the logic? You understand, please. See, if you are changing logic positive to negative or negative to positive, your nature of the gate will change. So there is a theorem that is called duality, and you remember we already read duality. It is your De Morgan theorem. So what is duality? Let's first understand. So if you want to convert from positive to negative logic or vice versa, in that operation, what you are doing actually, you are changing ones to zeros, you are changing ones to zeros, or you are changing zeros to one. Okay, so if you are changing, actually what you are doing, you are changing the binary digit 1 to 0 or 0 to 1 in both inputs and output of gate that we already did in the last slide. Okay, so this operation produces dual of function. Okay, so what we are actually doing, we are actually changing the polarity of all terminals. We are actually changing the polarity of all terminals. So already you saw that we are changing our polarity. This A, now polarity is A complement, B, it is B complement, it is Z, it is Z complement. So what you actually doing is, in the duality, actually you are changing the polarity of the terminals. So as a result, you will get the dual of the function. Or you can also say that you are actually converting AND operation to OR operation, or vice versa, means OR to AND. What my point? So two things we are doing in this theorem, that we are actually transforming AND operation to OR operation. Okay, or we are converting 1 to 0 or 0 to 1. These things we are doing. So opposite also, OR operation to AND operation. So to understand this thing, let's do one problem so that you will understand how to get the dual. Okay, so I am taking one example so that you will understand what actually I am saying to you. So I am taking one example, and the question is, you have to find the dual and complement of the function. So one example I will give you, and another I will ask you to do. So find the dual and complement of the given function. So one example I will give you, and another I will ask you to do by yourself. So first you please understand what I am doing here. So my question is, suppose this is a function f, and this function is dependent on three variables a, b, c. Okay, and I am saying my function is a complement, b complement, c complement plus a complement, b complement, c. For example, this is the function that has this expression. This is the Boolean expression, right? So I want to find the dual. So what I told you, if you want to find a dual and you have a Boolean expression, if you want to found a dual and you have a Boolean expression, what you will do? You will convert all AND operation to OR, or you will convert OR operation to AND. Okay, so I will do that. I will find the dual. So what I said, A is connected with A complement, is connected with B, and C complement with dot. So this is the AND operation, this is AND operation, this is OR operation, this is AND operation, this is AND. So what I said, dot will be replaced with the plus, and plus will be replaced with the dot. So see what I am doing, dot I am replacing with the plus. So this is plus, so I am replacing with the dot. See, variables are same, as it is I am writing the variable a complement, I am writing a complement b, I am writing b, c complement, I am writing c. So this is the dual of this function. Now I am saying to get the complement. The complement, that means f complement. So what f complement, actually you will do opposite, means if it is complement, you will do again complement. So complement of complement is original, b complement c dot a plus b plus c complement. So this is the complement of the function f. Got it? So what I did, for dual we change dot to plus, plus to dot, and for complement we change complement variable to non-complement, uncomplement, and complement variable to uncomplement variable to complement. So I will write here complement variable you convert to uncomplement, and uncomplement you convert to complement. That I did here for getting the complement. Got it? So this is the thing to get the duality. What I have in the given thing is Boolean expression. So for Boolean expression, if I want to find out the dual, we will convert dot to plus and plus to dot, and for complement we will take complement, we will convert complement variable to uncomplement, uncomplement variable to complement. So if you understand this, you just solve this. Another example, suppose this is a given expression. All of you please do this. I am writing one expression here, just you tell me the dual and then tell me the complement. So I will understand that you are listening me. Just tell me what is dual here. Everyone, just answer me. What I did for dual? Reply to me, all of you.
A plus B bar complement plus C bar.
A plus.
B complement.
Plus C complement. Next.
A plus.
No. Just I said you convert dot to plus, plus to dot only.
Dot,
right. This is plus now, so you will convert in dot. Next.
B. Plus C.
Plus, ma'am. Plus C.
Plus C. Okay.
B plus C.
Now everyone got it, right? So dual you found. Now complement. So you will get f complement. See, whatever result I am writing, it is f, and now I am writing f complement. Don't forget to put complement here, because you are now going to take complement of the function. So what I said to you, for complement, what will you do? This is my first variable, and this is uncomplemented, right? A is uncomplemented. A bar, right? Sign you will take same.
Plus. B plus C.
A plus C, good.
Dot.
Right.
B bar plus C bar.
Good. Okay, so you got it, right? So here I told you how to get the dual and how to get the complement of a Boolean expression. Got it? Any confusion? It is simple. Okay. So for homework, you do one thing, you find out. Now this is the another question, you just write for homework. Find dual of XOR is equal to its complement. Okay, so you will do this as a homework. Whole of X bar is equal to its complement. So same thing you apply and just you get out, come out with the answer, and you please tell me tomorrow. Now come to the another thing. Boolean, some terms I will tell. Boolean function. So boolean, what is boolean function? Actually, boolean function is described as an algebraic expression, and that algebraic expression will contain binary variables, or it may contains constant 0 and 1 and the logical operator. Got it? So what is boolean function? We already know, but I am telling you the definition. What is boolean function? Let's say boolean function is f. And what is boolean function? Actually, it is described by an algebraic expression. So I am showing you one example. So let's, it is a function that is a plus b prime c. So please, prime is actually complement. Okay, so you can write the over bar, or you can write this prime, same thing. So this is my algebraic expression, and this algebraic expression contains binary variables. So my variables are a, b, c. Three variables are there, and these variables are my binary variables, and these variables can take, you know, it can take either 0 or 1, and they are connecting together with the logical operator. You can see a logical operator plus is here, a logical operator dot is here. Okay, so b complement c, b complement is connected with the c with dot operator. So this is OR operator, this is OR operator, this is your OR operator, and this is your AND operator. Okay, so this is the expression, and this expression you contain a binary variable and it contains logical operators. So this is my boolean function. So we can evaluate the binary value of the output of this expression for all possible values of the variables. See, there are three variables here. You can see there are, in this function there are three variables. That means your function f, that function f is actually your output, and it is dependent on a, b, c. So what I am saying, that whatever f, whatever be the value of input variables, these a, b, c, that will decide the value of f. And what will be the value of f? It will depend upon the your algebraic expression, right? So whatever algebraic expression, you can see the output based on the all possible values of the variables. I will show you. So your boolean function can also expressed as a truth table. So just set your mind, your boolean function can be expressed as a truth table. It can also expressed as a algebraic expression. Okay, also you can transform your algebraic expression or equation into the logic circuit. We already did this last lecture. I gave you the expression, I asked you to convert this expression into the logic circuit. Okay, see, this thing you already did. So you just remember this point, that your truth table, there is only one way to represent a boolean function in the form of truth table, but there are various form in algebra, there are various forms of function in a algebraic. If you are expressing in terms of algebraic expression, there are various ways. So what are the various ways? Let me show you. So you remember some important points, that if you are taking a boolean expression, and that boolean expression you are going to implement with the logic gates, and you understand that each term in the expression is actually representing a gate. Okay, and each term each variable within a term designate an input to the gate. For example, if I am saying that this is the expression, so what I am saying actually, I am saying that in this expression, number of terms are, how many terms are there? Two terms are there. So two terms means we need two number of gate to implement these individual terms. If I want to convert this expression, this term into the hardware, that means I require one gate. Here I need one gate. So each term require a gate, okay? And each variable in this term, two variables are there. So for this gate, you have these variable as input, okay? So first term, it contains two variable. That means these two variable will actually designates an input to the gate, okay? And also in the function, your binary variable may whether in its normal form or its complement form. Means this is your variable. Suppose B is a variable, it is in the function in the C's. It is in uncomplemented form, and here it is in the complemented form. So any form, your algebraic expression can take. So binary variable can appear as in its normal form or in its complement form. So important point is, I already gave you one assignment. In that I asked you to come out with the minimum number of literals. So you may ask me, what is literals actually? What is literal? So you may ask me the questions. That's why I am giving you the information, what is literal. If suppose you have a function, like this, a plus b complement c. This is the function, and this function contains three variables. Okay, but here, what is literal? So literal is actually in each term, total variables, whether it is in normal form or in complemented form, is your literal. So here two terms are there. This is one term, this is second term. So two terms are there, but how many literals are there? One, two, three. So three literals are there in the function. So I gave you the question in the assignment that I asked you to simplify the complex Boolean expression into a simplest form. And I constrained you to come out with the two literal or one literal. So that you need to do, you just simplify and come out with the one or two literal. It is mentioned in the question. So if you understand what is literal, you just tell me how many literals are there, how many terms are there. Everyone, you just see what I am writing here. Tell me how many terms are there.
Three.
Three terms are there. How many literals are there? Terms are three. I now understand. Three terms are there. How many literals? So you will count the variable. How many variables I listed here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That I am saying, you just please confuse with the literal and variables. Please don't confuse with the variables and literals. Okay. So actually, variable is your set. This is your subset. So in literal, you will consider all variables that are in the expression. How many variables are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So how many literals are there? 8 literals. These two terms are not same. Got it? That's why I want to tell you that you please don't confuse with the variable and literals. Literals are the variable that are in the function. So how many variables are in the function in complemented and uncomplemented form in the expression? here it is 8. Got it? Now come to another thing. Now come to the another term called minterm. So you will see in the questions. Someone may ask you just to collect the minterm or you collect the maxterm. So your question may be what is minterm, or it is also known as standard product. So if suppose you have input as a truth table. See, this is my truth table, and I listed here all the possible combination for the three variables. This is the example I am explaining you. So I am explaining you what is minterm or standard product. Okay, so if suppose in a question, if you have three variable, if any function has three variable, you will list out all combination, all possible combination. So you know that if you have n variables, how many combinations, possible combinations are there? 2 to the power n possible combination. So here I have three variables, that is how many combination? 8. So I will list all 8 combination of the x, y, z. Okay, so this, if you see, this is the binary decimal equivalent, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever I'm writing here, it is a decimal equivalent of this combination. So you will write in a sequence. So this is in sequence 0 to 7. And what, to get the min term, what will you do? You will see the variable. This is 0, this is 0, this is 0. So your x is 0, your y is 0, and your z is also 0. So to get the min term, what will you do? If your variable is 0, you will take it as its complement form. So you will take x complement, you will take y complement, you will take z complement, and you will combine with the, you will do AND operation. You will do AND operation. That means in this term, all variables are present. All variables. So I am talking about the function that has three variables. So you see, all three variables are present in the term. And its binary equivalent, its decimal equivalent is 0. So you can write the expression that this min term as x complement, y complement, z complement. And you can also designate as min term. If you are mentioning min term, you will use small m, and you will write the decimal equivalent. So if decimal equivalent for this combination is 0. So from this 0, you can understand I am saying 0, 0, 0 condition and 0. As I said, if you are taking a min term, you will do you will take the complement of the variable. Now see the next case. It is 0, so I will take x complement. It is also 0, I will take y complement. It is z, I will take the z normal form. So you see, this decimal equivalent is 1, so I am writing a small m 1, and so on. So last case, it is 1, so I will take the true signal x, y, z, and I will combine with the AND operation. And it will designate as M7. So if I will write a function in the form of, let's say, M2, M4, M7. So what do you understand actually? Actually, I am telling you the function. I am telling you a Boolean function in the form of minterm. And you see that. This min term is actually showing you a standard product. Standard product, because it is a dot is there, so you will say product, and it contains all variables. That's why I am saying standard product. Got it? So in terms of min term, if I am representing a function and then all min terms I am summing, that is called sum of products. So this is a function that is sum of product form. So all products I am now summing. This is the product, this is the product, this is the product. This is min term, this is min term, this is min term. And I am summing all min terms. So that's why I am saying it is sum of products, or in short, I will say SOP. I will say SOP. Got it? So this is small m. By mistake, it is written capital M. So all terms you will designate as small m, and you will write a decimal equivalent, and you will get all terms related to all possible combination. Correspond to all possible combination, you will get the min term. So if you have a function, and just now I wrote, if this is another form to tell the expression, Boolean function. So earlier, what you know that this type of expression may be there, but now this is another way to represent a function. For example, m7 plus m4. So if your f is actually dependent on a, b, c, so you can also write in this form. So what is this actually? M7 means 1, 1, 1 means A, B, C. So if you convert this min term into the Boolean term, it is my A, B, C. Here decimal equivalent is 4. So binary equivalent for 4 is 1, 0, 0. So this is my A, this is my B bar, this is my C bar. So you see that this is another way of writing the Boolean expression or Boolean function in terms of min term. This is another form of expressing a Boolean function. Here I am telling you a SOP form. Got it? So if you understand, just you tell me the Boolean function, if it is this. And your now tell me the Boolean expression for this function. If you got it, you just tell me the Boolean function in terms of binary variables x, y, z. Now convert this min term. So one more important thing, you please remember that sequence also matters. So whether I am taking x, y, z, or whether I am taking z, y, x, or I am taking y, z, x. So this sequence also mattered there. So here, as I wrote z, y, x, so in the truth table also I will write this sequence. Okay, so truth table will be in this form. So you please remember what sequence actually you are taking to express the min term. So tell me what M0 represent here in terms of x, y, z. Everyone, just first what will you do? You will see the decimal equivalent and you will represent in the form of binary. So here three variables are there. So you will represent 0 in form of three variables. So what will be 0? Binary equivalent. It will be 0, 0, 0. Okay, what I said, f is your three variable function. So you will represent all decimal equivalent here in the subscript in the form of three variables. So here 0 decimal equivalent is equivalent to binary is 0, 0, 0. And what this 0, 0, 0 is actually, if I am taking this sequence z, y, x, so this is my z bar, this is my y bar, this is my x bar. Then plus, now tell me 5. Now write that binary equivalent for this 5. Always apply 8421. So you know that you are taking the 4, 3 variables. So that means you will take 4 to 1. So for 5, that means this position will be 1, this position will be 1. So this is 1, this is 0, and this is 1. Okay. So this is my binary equivalent of 5. So this is 1, this is 0, this is 1. So what will you write here term? See here, term variable I wrote here in the top. So you see, if one is there, you will write variable as it is, true signal. So here z is 1, so you will write z. 0, y is 0, so you will write y complement. X is 1, so you will write x. Now come, tell me 6, m6, you represent m6?
1, 1, 0.
1, 1, 0. Huh? Tell me the expression. Tell me the
expression. Z, Y, X, bar.
Good. Okay. Now you got it. Now I understand. You got it. 2 points. You please consider that while converting the decimal equivalent, you please always remember the how many variables are there, right? Okay. So let me change question again. So if suppose you have variable, this function is now 4 variable. So I am giving you another example, another question. Okay. Now, same thing I am telling you. Now you represent this function in terms of Boolean expression. Same in terms I am telling you, but now I am saying that function is now 4 variable function. Tell me the m0. What will you do? So you will take a, b, c, d, and you will represent this 0 in 4 bits. Got it? Why I am taking another example? Please don't confuse. You have to represent your decimal equivalent into the binary depending upon the number of variables. So here in the next example, I am saying now your function is 4 variable. It depends on 4 variable. So you have to represent this 0 in the 4 bits. Got it? So what is the binary equivalent for the 0 is this, right? Got it? Now represent the m5.
0101.
0101, got it. Okay, good. M6.
0110.
0110, got it. Okay, correct. So what I'm telling you, that please always you see how many variables are there and then you convert the decimal into the binary. Okay, so number of variable you should know and then you will convert into the bits. So now you expressed the m0 in terms of ABCD. What will be the m0? Tell me.
A bar, B bar, C bar, D bar.
Good. Next.
Plus. A bar, B, C bar, D.
Good. Next.
Plus A bar, B, C, D bar.
Good. Very good. So now you understand how to write the function. If you have a min terms, then you can convert the min terms function into the Boolean algebraic equation. Got it? And what is a standard product I said to you? Standard product, please don't confuse, because next time I will tell you another thing that is called canonical form. So you please understand what is a standard product. Again, I am telling you, what is a standard product or min term? What is a standard product or min term? It is a term that contains all variables, and all variables are connected with the AND operation. So if your function is 3 variable, let's say x, y, z, so this term should contain, if it is containing all 3 variables and they are ending and all variables are there, so I will say standard product. If I in my expression, if it is y, z bar is there, it is not a standard product. Got it? Here one variable is missing, x is missing, so this is not my standard product. Please don't confuse, this is not my standard product. This is my standard product. Min term is always a standard product that contains all variables. Got it? All variables should be there. If you want to write the the function in the form of min terms. That means each term should contains all variables. Each term should contain all variables. For example, if time is over, then you please remind me, because I cannot see the clock here. Okay. So what I am telling you, if this function is this, and this function, I am saying that this is a function that is three variable function. Okay. So this function expression is this. So can you see any standard product here or min term? Min term, is this a standard product? Is this a standard product?
No, ma'am.
No. Why? Because each term is not containing all terms. So I cannot write this term directly into M0, M1, M2, whatever be that. Okay. Okay. So you need to, what you need to do? You need to expand this expression so that each term should contains all variables. So you will apply a Boolean theorem. You will apply Boolean theorem. What is Boolean theorem? So this is another part of the top, another topic. So I will not go in that part. Just let me explain first what is min term or standard product. It is a term that contains all variables, either in the normal form or in the complemented form. What it, all terms will be there. So in this expression, it is not a standard product. So you cannot write directly into the min term. You have to do some calculation. You have to apply some Boolean theorem to get the min term. So this part I will discuss later. So I hope you got it. What is min term? Another thing is max term or standard sums. So another way of representation is, there is same truth table. You see, this is again a same truth table. I am showing you three variable truth table, but this is another form to representing things. So if we are taking, if variable is zero, we are taking uncomplemented form. If it is one, we are taking a complemented form, and we are connecting all the variables with the plus. All terms are there, then we say it is max term. Got it? So this will help you to get the complement of the function. Okay, so this is the technique here to convert. Actually, if suppose you have the AND or logic, you can convert OR AND logic. So actually, whatever I am telling you, max term and min term, it is actually convert AND OR implementation into the OR AND implementation. I am telling in terms of hardware conversion. So if we have AND OR circuit, so we can convert into the OR AND circuit. Okay, opposite we also we can do, means OR AND circuit we can convert into AND OR circuit. So this is the beauty of this explanation, that you will see what is max term, what is min term, then we will convert into the hardware easily. So you please understand how we can write max term. So max terms you will always write in the capital alphabet. Capital M we will use for max term, and whatever decimal equivalent, zero. So here this is a decimal equivalent zero. So you will take the variable as it is, and you will separate all variable with the plus. So you see x plus y plus z. Here x is zero, y is zero. You will take x plus y plus one. Z is one, so you will write z bar. Okay. So here actually, this represent a function with the you are actually finding the place where your output is zero. If you are selecting a max term, that means actually what you are observing that combination where your output is zero. So this is the way to write the standard sum. Again, I am saying each term each term contains all variables. So here, if you want to write a function, so what you will get? So I will express a function in terms of max term. So now your function will be expressed like this. Okay, so here actually three terms are there. Each term are separated with the dot. So that form is called product of sum. Product of sum. That form is called product of sum, and in short, I will say POS. So again, you can represent this function in the form of the max term. So I will previously I wrote directly, but there is another way to write max term, min term also. So we can use pi, and then we can list all the max term. So you will convert these term into the max term. So just see, if your variable is same, then you will use assume as 0. If variable is complement, you will assume as 1. So this is equivalent to what? This is equivalent to 1. So I will write capital M1. Now see this, A complement, that means you will write 1. It is B, so you will write 0. It is C, you will write 0. So what is the equivalent, decimal equivalent of this? It is 4. Again, you see here, it is A, it is B, it is C. That means it is your 0, it is your 0, it is your 0. So it is M0. So you can write some POS for, I will write in sequence, 0, M1, M4. Sorry, you can write like this, M1 dot M4 dot M0. So you will represent a function in terms of max term. I will write in sequence M0, M1. M4. So A plus B plus C bar dot A bar plus B plus C dot A plus B plus C, you can represent in this form also. So this is your max term. These are your max terms, and this form is called POS because all max terms are ANDed. AND operation is there. So I am saying product of sum. Or you can also write like this one. This is another form of writing the max terms. If pi symbol is there, so actually it is representing, this decimal equivalent is representing your max term. If sigma symbol is there and 014 is written, that means these are min terms. This is another way to write the function. So this is your POS form. This is your SOP form. So this is your POS form. This is your SOP form. So what I told you, min term is the term that contains all variable and they are ANDed. AND operation is there. In the max term, you will take all variable and you will do OR operation. Thank you. Okay. So just take last example. So if you got it, just do one thing. If you understand max term, one last example we will do for max term so that you will understand. So if suppose I am writing this. And this F is actually free variable. So I am writing this function. You please write fast what are the max term here, and you come out with the expression. in the form of variables x, y, z. So what pi 0636 actually representing? M0 dot M3 dot M6. Okay. Now represent x, y, z. See that max term and represent the x, y, z. Write the expression. 0 binary equivalent is 0, 0, 0 because 3 variables are there. 3, what is the binary equivalent?
0, 1, 1.
0, 1, 1. And 6?
1, 1, 0.
1, 1, 0. Huh. Okay, now write the expression max term. For 0, 0, 0 max term, what is max term here? What is max term here? It is x plus y plus z.
Plus z.
Now tell me max term for this 0, 1, 1. It is?
X plus y bar plus z bar.
Very good. Next.
X bar plus y bar
plus.
Plus
z.
Plus
z.
Z, good. Now you write this. Now write the final expression.
Z.
Now write the final expression. X plus y plus z. Now you are writing a second max term, so you will separate that max term with the dot. Okay. Then I will write next term. It is x plus y bar plus z bar plus x bar plus y plus y bar plus z. So this is my Boolean function. Got it? So you practice this in at your home. So again, I will tell you the conversion or different forms tomorrow. So you please practice for max term and min terms, because I will tell you technique called Karnaugh map. The Karnaugh map, every time function will be given. The function may be given in the form of algebraic expression. Function may be given in the form of group table. Function can be given in the form of max term. Function can be given in the form of min term. So any form will be given of the function. So you have to understand how to convert that form into the logic circuit. Understand? So you please learn this thing. So tomorrow I will come out with the some more things. So I hope that you will take interest. So I hope you understand what I told you today. So if any doubt, you just ask me and then you can leave. That is all for today. Any doubt, you ask me, otherwise you can leave. Okay. Any doubt? Okay, thank you all for joining me. So we will meet tomorrow. So please practice. I forwarded one book to you, Maurice Menno. You please see the question and you please solve.